Now let's see how to use the surface area analysis to find the area within 5 or 10 minutes walking distance from each student hall. The same workflow, create a new surface area layer, and then load students' housing as facilities. Open the analysis settings. Now the current default breaks is set at 5, meaning a surface area of 5 minutes walking will be created. If you want multiple surface areas at once, say 5, 10, and 15 minutes of walking, you can separate them with either a comma or a space. You might want to configure polygon generation here. By default, if you're creating multiple surface areas, they will be created in rings, so the 15 minutes walking area would not include the area covered by 10 minutes walking, and the 10 minutes walking area would not include what's within 5 minutes walking. For the purpose of this exercise, I'm gonna change it to disks, so the 15 minutes walking area will cover everything within 15 minutes of walking. You can also change the multiple facility options here. If you don't want the service areas to overlap, you can change it to not overlapping. Or if you don't care which facility it is, as long as it's covered by some facility, I can choose merge by brick value. Here we do care which student hall it is, so I'm leaving it as overlapping. Click solve. Now we have 18 polygons created. You can open the attribute table to see that we have 3 polygons for each student hall, 0 to 5, 0 to 10, and 0 to 15 minutes of walking. Now what do we do with these polygons? One thing you can do is to see which point of interest fall into or outside of walking distance from a student housing location. The GSU campus is pretty compact here. Everything seems to be within 15 minutes of walking. But a fair amount of buildings outside of the 10 minutes walking zone for some residence halls. We can't see very clear here with all the service areas overlapping each other. So let's do a spatial join to find out. Right, I'm joining GSU buildings to the service area layer. Here, I'm only interested in how many buildings fall inside each polygon, so I leave all these boxes unchecked because there's nothing interesting to calculate off the layer GSU building anyway. There will be a count field showing how many points fall inside it, so that's the field we're interested in. You can change the output location here. Alright, now if we open the attribute table of the joint output layer, you can see the numbers of buildings inside each polygon is shown here. Now we see Piedmont North has only 8 buildings within its 10 minutes walking distance, but Greek Housing has 36 and University Lofts had 38. Another thing to consider is the walkability score in the building's vicinity. We can use another spatial join to find out what is average walkability score of the street segments within the service area. Again, I'm using my random scores. Let's add it to the map. I'm doing another spatial join here using road segment, and here I'm calculating the average of my random walkability scores. Here, you can further compare the average walkability scores using the average walk. You might say it's not super accurate to simply calculate the average value of walk, as some street segments are much longer than others. By using the simple mean, they're giving the same weight. How can we weight the street segments with length? A simple solution is to go back to road segments and create a field containing the product of walkability score and shape length. And then we can calculate the sum with the spatial join. Then you can divide the sum of walkability times length by the sum of length to get the weighted average. Let's try it. I'm going to add a field called walk lump. Then use the field calculator. Calculate that as walk times shape lump. Now going back to the polygons created by surface area analysis, gonna join with sum instead of average selected here. So that's for all the road segments intersecting polygons, including those fall completely inside. Right here we have sum of shape length, that's the total length of road network falling into a service area, and then we have the sum of walkability score times length of these road segments. So to calculate the weighted average, we just need walk weighted and then we get the weighted average of the walkability score.